absolute pleasure to be learning the gospel with you today. Let's open our time with a word in prayer. Please bow your heads and close your eyes with me. Lord, thank you for our time together this morning. We pray that you'll help us to focus on you and what you have for us to learn. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, take a look at these two photos that are going to be on your screen in a minute and see if you can tell what's different about them. There are six differences, so see if you can spot them. You can even pause your TV if you need to do that, okay? Well, in today's Bible story, Jesus' disciples were meeting in a house when he suddenly appeared to them, just like the pictures we just looked at. Last week, we learned that Jesus appeared to two of his followers as they were walking to Emmaus. Jesus taught that all the scriptures point to him, but they weren't the only ones who doubted the reports that Jesus was alive. It was time for Jesus to prove himself to more of his disciples. That's where our Bible story picks up today. Sometimes good news seems simply unbelievable, which reminds me of a game called Believe It or Not. So here's how our game is gonna go. I'm gonna say different statements that are pretty outrageous, and you are going to tell me if you believe it or if you doubt it. I'm going to say my statement and then count to three. If you're watching from home, I want you to yell out the answer. If you're watching at church, we'll do something different and we'll explain in person. Okay, so here we go. Here's our first one. Bats are the only mammals that fly. One, two, three. Okay, the answer was true. Is that what you said? Number two. The pug is the smallest dog breed. One, two, three. False. It's actually the Chihuahua. Number three. A grizzly bear can run as fast as a horse. What do you think? One, two, three. That's true. All right, number four. A sneeze travels 200 miles per hour. One, two, three. That's false. I bet some of you, a lot of you said false. It actually travels 100 miles per hour. That's still pretty crazy. Number five, the North Pole is warmer than the South Pole. One, two, three. The answer is true. That statement is true. Did you guys know that? The more outrageous something is, the harder it is to believe. In today's Bible story, Jesus' disciples were told something they thought was completely outrageous. Jesus is alive. They had a hard time believing it. Listen to how Jesus proved his resurrection in our Bible story this week.
On the first day of the week, in the evening, the disciples gathered together in a house. They locked the doors because they were afraid of the Jews. They didn't want to be killed like Jesus had been killed. But some of Jesus' disciples had reported seeing him alive. Was it true? As the disciples talked, Jesus appeared among them and said, "Peace to you." The disciples were afraid. They thought they were seeing a ghost. "It's me," Jesus said. "Look at me and touch me. A ghost does not have flesh and bones, but I do." Jesus showed his disciples his hands and his side. They saw his wounds. The disciples rejoiced because they were so happy to see Jesus. The disciples gave Jesus some fish to eat. Jesus talked to them and explained the Bible to them. "The Bible is about me," Jesus said. He helped them understand how the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms told about him. Then Jesus told the disciples, that they had a job to do. Jesus had died and was raised from the dead so that people could be forgiven for their sins. The disciples needed to tell other people to repent from their sins and be forgiven. Jesus said, "God sent me to earth, and in the same way, I am sending you." One of Jesus' disciples, Thomas, was not with the others when Jesus visited him. He did not believe that Jesus was alive. Thomas said, "I want to see and touch the holes in his hands and his side, or I will never believe." A week later, Thomas was with the disciples when Jesus appeared again. Jesus said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Reach out and touch my side. Don't be an unbeliever. Believe." Thomas did believe. "My Lord and my God," he said. Jesus said, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Those who believe in me without seeing me are blessed." For 40 days, Jesus presented himself to more than 500 people and proved that he is alive. Jesus is still alive today. We have not seen Jesus, but if we believe in him, we will be blessed. He sends out believers to tell others about him and gives us power through the Holy Spirit.
Though we can't see Jesus today, with our eyes and can't touch him with our hands, we have the written testimony of those who did. We find them in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Listen to this.
John 20:29. "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed."
Okay, let's decode this message for Thomas by answering some true or false questions, kind of like we did before, but now having to do with the Bible. Here we go. Jesus said the Bible is all about him. Is that true or false? Your answer should be true. Next, the disciples thought Jesus was a ghost. True or false? The answer is true. John was missing when Jesus appeared. That is false. The disciples were afraid of the Greeks. False. Next one, Jesus ate fish. True. Jesus told the disciples to teach about him. That was also true. And finally, the disciples gathered on the last day of the week. That one is false. So what's the message? Did you guys figure it out by following along? That's right. The message is Thomas, believe. Jesus is still alive today. We have not seen Jesus, but if we believe in him, we will be blessed. He sends out believers to tell others about him and gives us power through the Holy Spirit. Which brings us back to our big picture question. Do you remember what it is? Where is Jesus now? The answer is Jesus ascended to heaven, where he is seated at the right hand of the Father. Do you believe this? It changes everything because Jesus is alive. We have hope for the future. Pastor Brian always has insightful and biblical answers to the tough questions that we ask, even some about doubt that may be difficult to talk about. Let's watch our video and hear what he has to say.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Skylar from Marion, Indiana asks,
"Sometimes I doubt God is real. Is that wrong? What should I do?"
Skylar, that is completely understandable. I think all of us have times where we question things about our faith, and some are big ideas like God's existence at all. Some are a little bit smaller things. But that is one thing that we all share in common, that faith at times is difficult. I've been there. I know as a father of three kids who are really learning about who God is and learning about the gospel, we have conversations in our home quite a bit about this. And so it's common, and here's the thing, it's okay. God understands that we have questions. He understands that there are times we're gonna doubt, and He is so kind, He's so loving and gracious to come and meet us where we are and take us where we need to be, deeper, stronger faith. And so it's okay. And here's the thing, doubting is normal. What you're not doing is rejecting. Those are two different things. Questioning, wanting to know God better, being confused about who He is and what He's done, that's normal. It's so different from rejecting God and saying, no, I know you're not real, or I reject who you are, or I reject what you've done. That's not what you're doing. So find comfort in that. You're not a bad Christian because you have questions. God invites us to bring questions to Him. That's what we love about God, that He is not threatened by our questions. He's not unnerved by our questions and our doubts. He is gracious to meet us where we are, again, and take us where we need to be. So here's a question for you to think about. What do you think is the difference between doubt and disbelief?
Let's stand together and sing our key verse, John 11:25, and then we'll play a little game to test your knowledge. Think you have it memorized? Okay, so this game requires a little bit of prep, so make sure to ask your grown-ups for help. And it's more fun with more than one person, so you can play this with other people in your house, or maybe you can video call a friend and play it with them as well. So to prepare for this game, you're going to print or write out John 11:25. And then you're gonna cut out each word separately, and then you're gonna stuff everything into a balloon and blow it up. I had to split my words between two balloons. And then you're gonna compete and see who can pop it and rearrange the verse in the correct order first. We've been learning about people groups from East Asia. Today, we'll take a glimpse of other people in East Asia. Missionaries have different ways to reach people, but the message is always the same. Jesus died and rose again. Jesus proved he is alive. Jesus showed Thomas his scars from the cross so that he could believe. Jesus knew his followers needed more proof as well. So for 40 days, Jesus presented himself to more than 500 people and proved that he is alive. Let's do a quick activity so we can remember the love God showed us when he allowed Jesus to die on the cross for our sins. You will need a piece of paper, scissors, something to color with, and two band-aids if you have them. If you don't have band-aids, don't worry, you can draw them in. I'll show you how to do both ways in this video. This is our last activity for the day, so before I send you off to do the craft, let's close in prayer. I'm going to fold my hands and bow my head. Jesus, thank you for knowing and understanding our fears and our doubts. Thank you for giving us the proof we need through your word. Thank you. We are so grateful that you are alive today. Help us to share these truths with others so they can know you and have eternal life too. Amen.